roads are brewing, mysterious fathoms below. Heave-ho!
I'll sing you a song of the king of the sea,
and it's hang to the starboard heave-ho!
The ruler of all of the oceans and seas,
in mysterious fathoms below.
Just perfection, Grimsby, out on the open sea, surrounded by nothing but water and imagination.
Oh, yes, it's simply delightful.
The salt in your skin and the wind in your hair and the waves as they ebb and they flow. We're miles from the shore and guess what? I don't care.
As for me, I'm about to heave-ho.
What is that? Do you hear something?
Please, enough seafaring. This talk about Marie pulling king of the sea, it's nautical nonsense.
There it is again, straight ahead.
Your Majesty, you've got to return to court and take up your father's crown.
That's not the life for me, Grimsby. Now follow that voice, to the end of the earth if we have to.
Aye, aye, Captain.
There's mermaids out there in the bottomless blue, and it's hey to the starboard he foe. Watch out for a ladder, you'll go to your ruin, mysterious fathoms
below. Merfolk, welcome. It's wonderful to see all of you here. Ever since the sea which robbed us of your dear queen, celebrations like these have lifted my spirits. Thank you.
Presenting the great composer, Horatio, Thelonious, Ignatius, Crustaceous, Sebastian!
Oh, sire, you're gonna love this number. I wrote it for my star pupil.
And who might that be?
Your youngest, such a voice, that child. Notes clear as ice, pitch as pure as water. Why, I haven't heard such magnificent sound since the queen.
May she rest in peace.
Oh, you're gonna be so proud. If only that girl would show up to rehearsals once in a while.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let the festivities begin.
Daughters of Triton, great father who loves us and named us well.
Aquata,
Andrina,
Arista,
Atina,
Del,
Alana, and Ariel.
In concert we hope to enlighten the hearts of the merfolk with music swell.
Aquata,
aha, aha, aha.
Our seventh little sister, we're presenting her to you to sing a song, Sebastian, where her voice is like a bell. It's our sister, Ariel. It's our sister, Ariel.
Not again, child. I was counting on you most of all.
Ariel, what in the name of Poseidon is that girl?
Hey, Ariel. There you are.
Just look, Flounder, the sun, the sand. Isn't it the most beautiful place you've ever seen?
I don't know, Ariel. I'm not so sure we ought to be up here.
Don't be such a guppy.
A guppy? I am not a guppy. I'm as brave as you are. I'm not afraid of anything.
Oh, yeah? What about sharks?
Whale!
Oh, Flounder, you really are a guppy.
I am not.
Aw. You'll never guess what I found today. Look! Have you ever seen anything so wonderful in your entire life?
Wow, cool. What is it?
I don't know, but I bet Scuttle will. Come on, I'll race you.
Scuttle!
Mermaid off the port bow. Ariel, how you doing, kid? Whoa, what a swim.
Scuttle, look what we found.
More human stuff, eh? Let me see.
Can you tell us what it's for?
Wow, this is special. This is very, very unusual.
What is it?
It's a dingle hopper.
A dingle hopper?
Oh, these babies are fantabulous. Absolutely indispensary.
When it comes to dinglehoppers, I'm the Regan Encyclopedia. Say that you wanna have a hairdo like the folks who live up there. You gotta flap the wings.
Flap the wings.
Fly up.
Well, you look absolutely dandy if you use one of these handy little thingamajigs.
Thingamabobs.
Jigs.
Bobs.
Up.
Pick up the dinglehopper just like so. Toward the way I'm twirling now. Give it a little yank, and there ya go. You're what they call the dogs, meow.
Wonderful stuff,
ock.
That human stuff, can't get enough,
ock.
Of human stuff, and we are the authority. No need for us to bluff, because we're great at explaining human stuff.
What's that?
A snufflat.
Wow!
When they invented snufflats, just by chance, suddenly life was la-dee-da. So what you use to make folks dance? Give it low and then voila!
Wonderful stuff. That human stuff. It'll get a buff. Of human stuff.
It's marvelous.
Stupendiful.
Completely A-O-J, which sounds absurd, but take my word,
that's what the humans say. Wonderful stuff. That human stuff, none of it fluff. Not human stuff. And heaven knows since we're the pros, from us you'll get no duff.
And once you got a who's-ma-jig,
a thingamawad,
a watch-ma-gig,
that's all you need to bring you up to snuff.
Right up to snuff with proper dingle hopper groom, and rest assured you'll look real human. We know, cause we know human stuff.
Ah! Does this thing really work?
Sure thing, kid. And I ain't just blowing smoke. It plays music of which the likes you've never heard.
Music? Oh no, the concert! My father's gonna kill me!
The concert was today?
I completely forgot. Come on, Flounder. Thank you, Scuttle!
Anytime, sweets. Anytime.
Oh, sorceress of the sea,
a beauty of the brine,
hail to sea witch,
hail to Ursula.
Flotsam, my pet, Jetsam, my darling, come to me, my little sea spies.
Mama's feeling woebegone, banished to the nether regions of the sea. No food, hardly any company, I'm simply just wasting away.
Poor Ursula.
Yes, poor me. What news do you have?
King Triton and Merfolk are celebrating your defeat,
and he blames you for the queen's demise.
Of course he does. Use a little black magic to help out a few merfolk, and this is the thanks I get. Well, now it's time to turn the Triads on Triton. We just need to find his Achilles heel, a weakness that'll crack his armor.
The king is terribly devoted to his daughters.
Especially the youngest, the one with the beautiful voice.
But she missed the celebration.
Apparently Ariel takes her gift for granted, just like her mother. A woman doesn't know how precious her voice is until it's been silenced.
Silenced.
You two find out what that girl really wants. Lure her to my lair. I'll whip up a spell to make her dreams come true. And then, my dear.
Yes?
Trident's crown and throne will all be mine!
Daddy, I'm so sorry. I just forgot.
As a result of your careless behavior.
Careless and reckless behavior.
The entire celebration was
ruined. Completely destroyed. This concert was going to be the pinnacle of my distinguished career.
Sebastian.
But I didn't mean to.
Ariel, listen. You've been given a gift. Your mother's voice. A wondrous talent that demands stewardship and care. So please, dear child, for the sake of her memory.
I know, Daddy. I know.
It wasn't even Ariel's fault. We were going to come back straight away. But then the seagull started going on and on about human stuff.
Seagull? Human stuff? You went up to the surface?
Nothing happened.
You could have been seen by one of those barbarians.
Daddy, they're not barbarians.
They're dangerous. Net, harpooned, you're my youngest.
I'm old enough to look after myself.
As long as you live under my reef, you obey my rules.
You're so unfair.
Oh, she's stubborn as a barnacle.
Teenagers, give him an inch and they'll swim all over you.
I can govern a kingdom, but I can't control my own daughter. Maybe I've been too harsh.
Nonsense, sir. If you ask me, you haven't been tough enough.
I haven't.
Ariel needs constant supervision. Someone to keep her safe. Out of trouble.
That's not a bad idea.
I'd say it's a right good one.
And you are just the crab to do it.
What?
You heard me. From now on, Ariel is your responsibility.
But, Your Majesty, she's a clever mermaid. I'm just a crustacean. Surely you ought to pick someone higher on the evolutionary ladder.
But who cares? No big deal. I want more. I want to be where the people are. I want to see, I'm dancing, walking around on those, what do you call them? Oh, feet.
Burn, no, it's in my turn. What did I love? Who had to
sick of swimming?
Out of the sea?
Tell me, child, got trouble in the mind?
Sebastian!
What is all this?
Just a few knickknacks I've collected, that's all.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself. If your poor father knew about this place, he'd...
You're not going to tell him, are you? Oh, please, Sebastian, he'd never understand.
Ariel, down here is your home. The human world, it's a mess.
Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you, what more is you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter, take it from me. Sure they work all day, out in the sun they save away, while we devoting full time to floating under the sea. Down here all the fish is happy, as off through the waves they roll.
The fish on the land ain't happy, they sad cause they in the bowl. The fish in the bowl is lucky, they in for a worse fate. One day when the boss gets hungry,
guess who gon' be on the plate?
Uh-oh, under the sea, under the sea.
Nobody beat us, fry us and eat us in fricassee.
Under the sea,
we want the locals up to cook. Under the sea, we have the milk.
We got no troubles, life is our bubbles. Under the sea.
The harp, the place, play the bass,
and they sound a jar.
The bass play the bass, the chug play the chug, the fluke is the dope of soul.
The ray, he can play the lings on the strings, the trout rocking out the back, fish he sings, the smelt and the sprat, they know where it's at, and know that glowfish blows.
That's what I'm talking about. Ariel? Hello? Oh, somebody's gotta nail that girl's fins to the floor.
I don't want to be king.
I swore an oath to your dear father's deathbed. I turn you from a roustabout into a royal and have you married to a princess. By your next birthday, which is now just 3 days away.
Have you ever tried to take a princess sailing? It's a joke. Their dresses get caught in the rigging. And most of them can't even swim.
You know there's more to a woman than a flutter kick. Our kingdom needs a queen.
Where am I going to find her, Grimsby? A girl who's as carefree and alive as the sea itself. Where?
Wow.
It's too much to hope for, isn't it? A girl who's the right match for a guy like me?
Perhaps you're not looking hard enough.
I've never seen a human this close before.
Me neither.
Shh, I thought you were an expert.
On their stuff? Sure. But yikes, the sight of him? Hideous, ain't he?
I don't know. I think he's really handsome. Trust me, Grimsby. When I find the girl of my dreams, it'll hit me like lightning.
hurricane a-coming. Captain, King Triton must be angry indeed.
Batten the hatches and everyone below deck, and quickly!
Whoa, the wind's on the move here.
Careful, Scuttle!
Ariel!
The ship's listing badly.
Oh, good heavens!
Shakir the rigging. Eric, take the wheel.
Help!
Man overboard. He's breathing. Oh, Scuttle, just look at him. He's so beautiful.
What would I give to live where you are? What would I pay to stay here beside you? What would I do to see you smiling at me?
Ahoy, somebody, anybody!
On your way, kid, before we discovered.
Prince Eric, are you alright? Get away, you filthy bird!
A girl rescued me. She pulled me right out of the surf, and she was singing.
There, there, now, dear boy, you took a terrible tumble.
No, I must find her and thank her for saving my life.
Come with me, a night's sleep and you'll be good as new.
That voice, I can't get it out of my head.
You've heard too many tall tales, my boy.
No, she was real.
Yes, Prince Eric, she was real. As real as a mermaid on the rocks.
Prince Eric.
I don't know when, I don't know how, but I know something's starting right now.
Ariel, that's who.
What about her?
She sure is acting fishy lately.
I'll say, swimming in circles, chasing her tail.
That girl's up to her gills in something. She's dizzy and she's dreamy.
Her head's up in the foam.
Her eyes have gone all gleamy. It's like there's no one home.
She floats away the days, moping on a coastal shell.
She you
or a they?
Is it water on the brain?
What has got her bothered so?
It's the bends, it's the blue.
Gosh, I wish we had a clue.
Oh wait, oh dear, good grief, it's clear she's in love.
Hello.
little Ariel, so that explains it. Just a minute there, Flounder.
Who, me?
You know Ariel as well as anyone. Who's the lucky merman?
Gee, I don't know. I didn't even know his love until the second chorus.
Sebastian, any ideas?
I've tried to stop her, sire, but she doesn't listen. I tell her, Ariel, you've got to stay away from those humans. They're nothing but trouble.
Humans? What about humans?
Who said anything about humans?
Sebastian, have you been keeping secrets from me? Where is that girl?
Now, let me see. What did Scuttle call this one? A diddy whopper? Thumb noodle? Whatever it is, Prince Eric held it in his own strong, beautiful human hand.
Ariel, what is all this?
Daddy, they're my...
human junk?
No, treasures.
Did you save a human from drowning?
He would have died.
That savage brute could have killed you, and it's my job to keep you safe from harm.
But he didn't. He made me feel wonderful. Besides, I'm not a child anymore.
No, but you sure are talking like one. He's a human. You're a mermaid.
It doesn't matter. You don't understand. I wish Mother were here.
Ariel, listen. I miss your mother just as much as you do, but I'm still the king. And you are never to swim to the surface ever again. Am I clear? I'm just trying to protect her, Sebastian.
She'll be all right, sir. Just give her some time.
I hate him.
Ariel, don't say.
And some friend you turned out to be. Spilling everything.
I couldn't help it. He had my claws in a clamp.
I don't need you. I don't need any of you. Go away. I said go away. I don't belong here. If only I could be... up there.
Poor, sweet, misunderstood child.
She has a very serious problem, hasn't she?
Who will ease her woes and worries?
Who will help her get her man?
Perhaps the sea witch can.
How did you...
She's been dying to help you.
Ursula? Help me?
Yes, but she can't leave her lair.
Then take me to her.
Of course.
Hello? Ariel, where'd you go? Oh no, Sebastian!
I don't know if...
Now.
Mustn't get cold, Fins.
Don't be shy, Ariel, darling.
I shouldn't be here. Mother died because of you.
Oh, what happened to your dear, sweet mother was a terrible, unfortunate accident.
An accident?
But, of course, I did my very best to save her.
But Father told me...
The truth is, the ocean wasn't big enough for your father and me. So he sent me here, and now I see he's driven you away, too.
He doesn't understand me.
Oh, but I do, Cupcake. We're very alike, you and I. Gals with ambition. Now tell me absolutely everything.
I'm in love with someone.
A prince, I hear. Quite a catch. Well, the answer is you've got to become a human yourself.
You can do that?
My dear sweet child is what I live for, to help unfortunate merfolk like yourself. Poor souls, with no one else to turn to. I admit that in the past I've been a nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me well a witch. But you'll find that nowadays I've mended all my ways, repented, seen the light, and made a switch. True? Yes. And I fortunately know a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. And here lately, please don't laugh, I use it on behalf of the miserable, lonely, and oppressed. Pathetic, poor, unfortunate souls, in pain, in need,
looking to be thinner.
That one wants to get the girl.
And do I help them?
Yes, indeed.
Those poor unfortunate souls.
So sad, so true.
They come flocking to my cauldron crying, spells are slow, please. And I help them?
Yes, I do.
Now it's happened once or twice. Someone couldn't pay the price. And I'm afraid I had to rake them across the gold. Yes, I've had the odd complaint. But on the whole, I've been a saint. To those poor, unfortunate souls.
I have a spell that'll turn you into a human for 3 days. Before the sun sets on the third day, you've got to get dear old Princey Poo to kiss you. If you do, you'll stay human forever.
And if I don't?
You'll turn back into a mermaid and your soul will be mine forever. Life's full of tough choices, isn't it? Of course, there is one more thing. My fee.
But I don't have any.
I'm not asking for much. Only your voice.
But if I give away my voice, how can I ever...
You'll have your looks. Your pretty face. And don't underestimate the importance of...
body language. Come on, you poor, unfortunate soul.
Go ahead. Make your choice. I'm a very busy woman and I haven't got all day. It won't cost much. Just your voice.
You poor, unfortunate soul.
It's sad, but true.
If you wanna cross a bridge, my sweet, you've got to play a toll. Take a gulp and take a breath and go ahead, achieve your goal. Flotsam, jetsam, now I got it, boy. The boss is on a roll. You poor, how's about it, Cupcake?
If I become human, will I ever see my family again? My sisters, Daddy?
Now do you want Princey Poo or not? 5, 4, 3, 2...
Yes, yes, I'll do it!
That a girl, now.
Beluga, Savuga, come winds of the Caspian Sea!
Larynxis, glissitis, adnax, laryngitis, labocetomy.
Now sing, sing your voice over to me. Sing, and keep singing.
What have you done?
Well, look who got beached. Hi, Ariel. Wait, there's something different about you. Don't tell me. It's your new hairdo, right? You've been using the dingle hopper. No? I can't quite put my foot on it right now.
She's got legs, you idiot.
Ariel traded her voice to the sea witch to become human.
Not, kid. Not your beautiful pipes.
And now she's got 3 days to make Prince Eric fall in love with her. And to prove it, he's got to kiss her.
The prince? Well, I'll say.
Hey, what have we got? Shoo! Shoo! Ah! Ah! Miss, are you all right? You seem very familiar. Of course, it's you. I've been looking for you everywhere. What's your name? Oh, sore throat, huh? You don't speak at all? I'm sorry. For a moment, I mistook you for somebody else. What? What is it? You're hurt? No, no. You need help. Well, I've got just the remedy. A warm bath and a hot meal. Come on now. The palace isn't far.
Way to go, Ariel!
That's what I call reeling him in.
Oh no, I've got to follow her. This is gonna get me in real hot water.
Can you believe that guy? What a crab.
The things I do for that girl. Over the wall, under the gutter, in through the window. Now, finally, someplace that's safe. Uh-oh.
Les poisons, les poisons. How I love les poisons. Love to chop and to serve little fish. First I cut off their heads, then I pull out their bones. I'm more weak, ça c'est toujours delish. Les poisons, with a cleaver I hack them in two. I pull out what's inside, then I serve it up fried. God, I love little fishes, don't you? Here's something for tempting the palate. Prepared in the classic technique. First you pound the fish flat with a mallet. Then you slash through the skin, gives the belly a slice. Then you rub some something, 'cause that makes it taste nice.
Les poissons, les poissons, to la mer, you they are safe for sure, to our friends from the sea.
Fish fillet,
fish pâté,
fish fillet,
fish tartare, it's a fish, how you say, jamboree.
Skipper smell!
Fish kebab! Tuna melt! If it's grilled, it's been grilled to a tea!
Fish lightly toasted and roasted and steamed, tossed in the blender and tenderly creamed.
Dish after dish like you wish you had dreamed! Zootalos, I have missed one!
Washing up like that, it must have been a horrible shipwreck. I don't suppose we'll ever know why you can't even speak. Oh, poor dear. Well, never mind that. After scrubbing the tub, you'll be as fresh as daisy in a beautiful new flock.
Why? Now I'm the one who's speechless.
It's been a long time since we died in the company of such loveliness.
Usually it's just me and Grim. He's got to look across the table at my ugly mug.
You might say your mystery guest is Grim for a groom, you might say.
Easy, old boy. Easy. She has no voice.
Oh. Oh, dear.
My, isn't that unusual? Thank you.
Don't tell me she's fond of pipes. I can't say I blame you. That's an antique from Dusseldorf.
Sorry, old friend, but it looks like your pipe smoked you.
Very amusing, yes. Well, she certainly knows how to make you smile.
Come on, Grimsby. Let's leave the two young ones alone for a bit.
You should see the princesses that Grimsby drags to dinner. So prim and boring. But you, if you don't mind my asking, what was it, anyway? An accident when you were young? I'm sorry. I didn't mean... Who needs words anyway? A smile can say just as much sometimes.
You're nibble on your feet, aren't you? Well, dancing beats small talk any day. It's the way your legs smile or laugh. It lets you say so many things.
Dancing is a language that is felt instead of heard.
whisper, sing, or shout without so much as a word. Try it, go on, like so. Just let your emotions tell your body what to do. See how much a single gesture can reveal. And every little step, every single step is one step closer to saying how you feel.
Forgive me, there's this voice. It's been haunting me. Anyway, I should let you get some sleep. Good night!
Out of the frying pan, into the fire, the things I do for you, young lady. Now, I shall march you right back home to your father. So you can be miserable the rest of your life. It's true. I got no backbone. All right, I'm in, but we got to get that boy to kiss you before it's too late. Here's a few pointers from a clever crab to a little mermaid. First, you got to bat your eyes, like this. And pucker your lips, like this. Oh, that's good. You put those two things together tomorrow, and you got that boy in the palm of your hand.
No girls ever dared to join me out here, too afraid they'd muddy their shoes. But not you. Peaceful, isn't it? Not another living soul for miles and miles. If only...
Hi there, what's happening?
Nothing is happening.
Shh. They spent all morning on horseback, then an afternoon picnic, now this, and not so much as a peck on the cheek.
Oh no, there's only one day left.
We gotta do something. Quick.
This could be our last chance.
We gotta create the right kind of mood. You mean like candlelight and champagne?
Nonsense, it don't take all that. Everything we need, we got right here. Percussion. Strings. Winds. Words. There you see her.
Sha-la-la.
Sitting there across the way.
Sha-la-la.
She don't got a lot to say, but there's something about her. And you don't know why, but you're dying to try. You wanna
kiss that girl. Yes, you want her. Look at her, you know you do.
Possible she wants you to. There is one way to ask her. Take a word, not a single word. You want to kiss a girl. Sing with me now.
Sha la 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 la, my oh my. Look like the boy too shy. Ain't gonna kiss a girl. Sha la 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 la, ain't that sad? Ain't it a shame? Too bad. He's gonna miss the girl.
You know, I really ought to know your name. Maybe I could guess. Alexandra, Annabelle, Beatrice,
Ariel. Her name is Ariel.
Ariel? Ariel. Hey, that's kind of pretty. Okay, Ariel.
Sha la 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 la, float along and listen to the song. The song say, kiss the girl. Sha la 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 la, music play, do what the music.
bigger.
Oh, no, you don't.
Quick, walk that kiss.
Whoa, what just happened? Ariel, are you all right? Well, we better get going anyway. I gotta rest up for my birthday tomorrow. Old Grimsby's planning a ball to help me find the girl with that voice. He wants me married by sunset, or else.
Dearest, I can't believe you've been with us for 3 whole days already. It's been such a treat. Now, the princesses are arriving to sing for Prince Eric. We can finally choose his bride. You just sit back here with Carlotta while royalty mingles. It should be quite a show.
Welcome, dear friends, to our contest, the first that our kingdom has ever seen. We gather today for a vocal display, so our prince may at last choose a queen. These 6 princesses possess the most accomplished voice in the land. Tonight, one of you will join Prince Eric on the throne. May the best woman win! One of these lovely voices matches music to your heart.
I wish I could say yes, but she's not here.
Sun has nearly set and your birthday will soon be over. You must choose a mate!
Ariel?
Oh, dear one.
Heaven's sakes, child.
Quiet, Grimsby. Go ahead, Ariel.
Oh, child, poor lost child.
Oh, dear Eric, I hope you find some love in this room.
I have, Grimsby. I've just been too blind to see it until now. Come here, Ariel.
Can it be another contestant?
But, oh, that voice. But tell her the contest's over. I've made my choice.
Why, look, such a beautiful sunset, and on the third day, 2. Time's up, mermaid. You lose.
Oh, no, the worst is happening. I've got to help.
Ariel!
My heavens!
She's jumped in the sea. I have to go after her.
Seen you for 3 days. I'm worried. I thought you might be here. I've come to apologize.
Most merciful Triton.
So where have you been, Sebastian? And where is Ariel?
Oh, she'd be so angry if she knew I was here.
I entrust my youngest daughter to you, and what happened? She disappears. I ought to have you cracked and shelled.
He almost was, Your Greatness.
What kind of tragedy will it take?
A tragedy involving the sea witch?
What?
Don't be a guppy. Don't be a guppy. You see, Your Majesty, these 2 slippery eels came and took Ariel to Ursula, and she traded her voice for a pair of legs.
She bartered her voice away to become a human?
Yes, and now the child has given up her very soul.
Oh, Ariel, what have you done? Come, we must save my daughter.
So
say goodbye to your prince. You're mine now, mermaid. Get ready to spend the rest of your days as my slave.
Ursula!
King Triton, right on cue.
What have you done to my daughter?
She's done it all to herself. Traded her voice away for what, human heartbreak?
Give her back to me.
Not on your life.
It so happens that your daughter made a bargain.
No!
Swapped her voice to land a man up where it's dry. Is it binding goodness? Yes. Unbreakable unless...
Unless?
There is a little something we could try.
Go on.
Yes. Perhaps we could arrange some sort of trade-off. Maybe swap your daughter's soul for, say, your own.
What?
Make this deal and set her free, or else she comes with me to suffer through eternity alone.
It's not my soul you're after, it's my power.
Now, which would you rather be, king of the sea or father to his little girls?
The trident is a great responsibility, Ursula.
Nonsense, trite one. Hand it over. Finally, the oceans belong to me! And now you poor unfortunate souls, time's up, you're through! Now the power of Poseidon has been once again made whole, all the magic of the Triton in the shell of my control, and now dark shall reign forever and ever, an ocean, sea, and shore! Now see for yourself how banishment feels. You poor unfortunate soul.
What's this? A human ship?
Ha! Who are you, and what have you done with Ariel?
Careful, Prince Pooh. Water's looking awful choppy.
Beware, monster. King Triton rules over these seas.
Not anymore.
I won't let you harm her.
Captain, we have to turn back or she'll pull us under.
Look out, the shell.
You fool.
You witch.
Stop there, sea snake.
My voice. Well, look who's talking. No matter, I have what I want now, and you don't.
You may have my father's trident, but you'll never have his power.
You impertinent mermaid, I'll dispatch you as easily as I eliminate your mother.
So father was right.
Yes, father was right, and now you'll see how insignificant merfolk become when Ursula's in charge. With trident in hand, I shall unleash the power of Poseidon to destroy you all. Oh, wait. No, I can't control it.
Ariel, the triton.
No!
Right, child?
Yes, thank you so much for all your help.
Not such a guppy anymore, am I?
No, you're the best friends a girl can ask for.
Ariel!
Daddy! I caused so much trouble. Can you ever forgive me?
Why? I've never been prouder. Somehow, in the blink of an eye, when my back was turned, you grew up. You love him very much, don't you? Belong to his world now.
Thank you, Daddy. Thank you so much.
But just remember, when you hear the surf roar at night and you feel the tingle of salt in the air, it's just your father checking in on his little girl.
Ariel! Who are you?
I'm her father, King Triton, and you're the human who came to her rescue.
With all due respect, sir, Ariel is the one who has done the rescue.
King of the sea? And she's his daughter?
Does that upset you?
Heavens no, I'm just relieved she's royalty.
Your Majesty, at last I've found someone who makes me eager to seize the future and claim my birthright as king. But if I slip out to see sometimes, I hope she'll be here right beside me. May I have her hand?
Ariel can speak for herself.
She can?